I'm currently planning a video about a special Windows tablet computer. What better OS to demonstrate on it than Windows 8, which is designed for tablets? Unfortunately, due to reasons I will explain in that video, or maybe you could guess, I can't run Windows 8 on it, so I thought about doing remote desktop. But wait, I just upgraded my Windows 8 computer to 10 in my last video. Well, didn't I say Windows 10 also has a tablet mode that's about as good as the Windows 8 user interface? Sure, but I have other computers with Windows 10, so I'm just gonna try its tablet mode there. Therefore, as much as this pains me, I'm gonna try downgrading from Windows 10 to Windows 8. Reluctantly, but this is for science. You've only got 10 days after the upgrade to do this, after which the backup files for the older OS are permanently deleted, so I had to act fast. It asks why you wanna downgrade, so I answered with the truth. The downgrade was pretty quick and only took about 5 minutes, and I genuinely got sad when I saw the Windows 8 login screen again. But let's try to look at the bright side. My computer collection isn't huge, but I have a computer for Windows 98, one for XP and Vista, one for 7, and two for 10, so I might as well have one for 8 too. And nothing prevents me from putting back 10 or another OS on this computer if necessary. So let's see what's going on after committing this atrocity. There's an error about Microsoft Edge, probably because it had updated to a newer version while running Windows 10. My main web browser is Firefox, but Edge is good as a secondary one, so I went to Microsoft's website to reinstall it. And it still had my profile stored, which is great. Everything else is working normally. Well, as normally as Windows 8 can work, of course. And then I realized something that foiled my initial plan. I wanted to do remote desktop, but this computer has a license for Windows 8 Home, not Pro, so it does not natively support hosting remote desktop. I have to resort to a third-party program for that. However, that's not the point of this video. I'll have to explore more of that later and show it in my future video about that tablet. For now, the downgrade was successful. I highly recommend against downgrading, unless you really really have to. Like, for example, you have a severe problem on Windows 10 you can't solve. Or like my case, where this is a spare computer not used regularly, and I wanted to compare Windows 8 to 10. I still think Windows 8 has no advantages over 10. Thank you for watching.